Good evening, class 6th. So today we are going to discuss the adverbs again so that it will be easier for you to understand it properly. So you can open your grammar books, page number 70. Yes, I think it's yes. It's page number 70. Please open your grammar books and I'll read it for you and I will explain you with it. So we have already discussed it. I will just briefly explain you now. So adverbs, I have already told you, are the words that are used in sentences to describe or change the meaning of the adjective or even the another adverb. So they add description to the sentence to make the detailed, make it detailed or interesting. It is like a word modifier. It describes the verb, adjective or any other adverb in the sentence. So we'll read out. He walked slowly across the square. Here you can see that adverb slowly describes the verb walk. It was raining heavily. Here the adverb heavily describes the verb raining. His clothes are partly wet. Here you can see that the adverb partly describes the adjective wet. How much it is wet? Adha sukha hai ya adha gila hai? Ye aapko partly se hi pata chalega. They are playing cards upstairs. Kahan par khel rahe hain? Where they are playing? They are playing upstairs. So you get the place. She has not come here before. Here it describes the verb come. So yahan pehle kabhi nahi aayi. Before. Always lock your car. Here we can see that adverb always is describing the verb lock. Why is Gina crying? Here you can see that the adverb why seeks to get the reason, the verb crying. Why that girl is crying? So here it is the interrogative adverb. They have almost reached. So here you come to know that to what degree that thing has happened. So they have almost reached means lagbhag wo pahunchne hi wale hain. So now we will start with the exercise number 1. If you people do this exercises in your notebook, so you can do it. I will send you the answers and I will discuss it orally and I will send you the answers, image of the answers. We'll start with exercise number 1. Our results will be announced tomorrow. So here the adverb is tomorrow. Underline tomorrow. In spring, flowers bloom everywhere. Here it is telling you the place. It's everywhere. Sheena knits woolen cardigans fast. So at what speed means she knits fast manner. He meets his doctor every week. Here it tells about the frequency. How many times? At what interval? Every week. Here, every week. She visited the hospital yesterday. It is telling you about the time yesterday. The thief quietly slipped away. Quietly. Chup-chap. Dad likes to watch TV every day. It is telling you about again about the time. Then Dia almost finished her assignment. Almost. It is telling you to what degree. Okay. So we'll move to next page. Here I'm going to explain you briefly again the kinds of adverbs. Adverb of manner. It is used to express the manner in which the action takes place. Like it answers the question how. Maine aapko kal samjhaya tha na. She spelled the word incorrectly. How? Incorrectly. Theek hai? Isse aapko pata chal jata hai ki usne word kaise pronounce kiya tha. Incorrectly. He hastily changed the subject. Usne subject kaise change kiya? How she changed the subject? Hastily. Matlab bahut jaldi se. So it is telling you about the manner. Action kaise ho raha hai? It answers the question how. So after reading the sentence you will ask yourself the question, and if the question starts with how, that means it is the adverb of manner. I would willingly pay more for better services. Willingly means, again, it is telling about manner. She dances well. How she dances? She dances well. Achha dance karti hai. Now the second one, adverb of degree, it explains the degree or the intensity. It answers the question to what extent. So the first one is, I have fully recovered from the accident. Fully means puri tarah se. Aapko pata chal gaya kitni degree tak wo theek ho gaye? Fully. This room is not big enough for me. Itna bada nahi hai. Not enough. Itna bada nahi hai. She sings pretty well. Pretty well means kafi achha. Degree pata chal rahi hai na aapko uski. I am quite happy. Quite happy here means kafi khush. Is it clear? Now we move to adverb of place. It is used to explain where an action takes place and it answers the question where. My mother has gone out. Now ask yourself where? Out. You get the answer out. Come here. Where? Here. He lives there. Where? There. Wo wahan rehta hai. I search for my lost book everywhere. Aapne kahan kahan search kiya? Everywhere. So it is telling you about the place. Now comes the adverb of time. It is used to explain time when the action takes place. Where the action takes place. When the action takes place. Sorry. So it answers the question when. Shatabdi Express arrived late. टाइम से पता चल रहा है ना आपको वो जल्दी आई या लेट आई तो यहां पे लेट मींस टाइम ही हैड लेटली रिटर्न फ्रॉम कैनेडा आपको पता चल रहा है कि वो कब आए थे कैनेडा से आई थिंक वी हैव मेट बिफोर हम पहले भी मिल चुके हैं मींस पहले एक बार मिल चुके हैं मींस टाइम का पता चल रहा है कि हम पहले एक बार मिले थे शी विल रिटर्न सून जल्दी जल्दी घर आ जाएगी Ranit take exercise daily. Daily means aapko roz. Pata chal raha time. Now comes the adverb of frequency. It is used to explain how often an action takes place. And it question answers the question how often. How often. So I have told you once. Maine aapko ek baar bataya. Now if I say I have explained you adverbs twice. मैंने आपको दो बार एडवर्ब समझाए तो इट इज द एडवर्ब ऑफ फ्रीक्वेंसी सोनिया सेल्डम टेल्स अ लाई सोनिया बहुत कम झूठ बोलती है सेल्डम बहुत कम वेरी रेयर शी समटाइम्स राइट्स टू मी कभी कभी समटाइम्स कभी कभी तो इससे आपको फ्रीक्वेंसी का पता चला कि एक्शन कितनी बार होता है I usually go by car. मैं अक्सर कार से जाता हूं तो ये जो सारे वर्ड्स होते हैं once, seldom, twice, thrice, weekly, monthly, ये सब आते हैं एडवर्ब ऑफ फ्रीक्वेंसी में Now comes the interrogative adverb. It is used to ask the questions related to an action. Action से related question पूछता है वो So where does she live? Now here It is asking about where does she live. Live is the action here and it is asking about where. So, the action word is live and the adverb is where. How did you do it? Here, the action is do and how is the interrogative adverb. When do you get up? When is the interrogative adverb here? Why are you late? आप late क्यों हैं? इसका reason वो पूछ रहा है और यहां adverb हुआ why. Now here actually exercise number 1 उसका थोड़ा सा पार्ट रह गया था तो वो भी हम कर लेते हैं it has been left I have not seen so up till 8th I have done the 9th one is they will certainly like your gift here the word is certainly 10th he never leaves his house unlocked here the word is never Luckily, the dog did not bite the child. Luckily, we have completely surprised by the. We were completely surprised by the snowstorm. Completely, Okay, is it clear? Should we move? Now comes the exercise number 2. Choose the correct adverb and insert it in the following sentences. You have to tick the right answer. So here we'll start. First one is done for you, and I'm doing the next one. I found his home very easily. Tick the word easily. Second, Tushar behaves very politely. Tick the word politely. My father will be out of the town this weekend. Tick the word out. Dipesh plays tennis well. Tick the word well. Mr. Raman doesn't mind anything and hence looks happy every time. Hence. Neighbors call the fire station immediately. Miss Shetty is a highly paid employee. Highly. Our school bus was stuck in a jam for nearly 2 hours. How often? It tells you about the frequency. How many times? How often? Sam was extremely happy. Bahut khush tha. Okay? Is it clear to everybody? Now we come to page number 73, exercise number 3. Here again, the help box is given and you have to fill the right. You have to form the adverbs and write the correct adverb here. Now, the first one is done for you. Raju and Sujata got married recently. They live happily in their rented house. They are working hard. Here, the word is hard. They are working hard to save money and buy their own flat. They never drive fast or carelessly. They never drive fast or carelessly. Either you write while I am explaining or I will send the answer key to you. So it's better if you write down as I am speaking. They are working hard to save money and buy their own flat. They never drive fast or carelessly. They have decorated their home beautifully. They treat their neighbors politely. They never speak angrily and always pay their electricity bill timely. They have their dinner early and take exercise regularly. They plan their weekends wisely and never waste their time. Okay, I will send the answer key to you. Now comes the exercise number 4. Rewrite the given sentences after changing the underlined words into adverbs. Here the sentence can be changed. Okay. When you will form the word, the adjective to the adverb, so sometimes the sentence also changes. Sometimes nahin, hamesha hi change ho jata hai, jab aap usko adverb mein change karte hain. Mom baked the cake in a perfect way. Now if we change it from perfect to perfectly, so it will be mom baked the cake perfectly. Second one is Sarah dresses in an elegant way. Elegant way. It will become elegantly. Sarah dresses elegantly. Josh is a good swimmer. Josh swims well. Josh swims well. Mohit is a bad driver. Mohit drives bad. They are hard workers. They work hard. Miss Lal is an effective teacher. Miss Lal teaches effectively. Dhruv is a neat writer. Dhruv writes neatly. The children play in a noisy way. Children play noisily. Children play noisily. Sheena is a good counselor. Sheena counsels well. Suzanne worked at a rapid speed. Suzanne worked rapidly. Suzanne worked rapidly. So for today, I think it is more than enough. आप इतना काम कर लीजिए जितना मैंने समझाया है उसको पूरा रिवाइज कीजिए. रिवाइज वट एवर आई हैव एक्सप्लेन्ड इट टूडे अगेन. गो थ्रू द एक्सरसाइजेस. ट्राई टू सॉल्व देम योर सेल्फ एज आई हैव डिस्कस्ड इट. एंड मोर ओवर आई विल सेंड द आंसर की टू यू एज एन इमेज. सो इट इज ओवर फॉर टूडे. थैंक यू.